The Germans called her Kuchen, or Cookie. This little blonde pixie from Los Alamitos, California, Cathy Rigby, 4'11" and just 89 pounds. Unbeaten on the balance beam for 2 years, training for 2 years, 7 days a week. She was America's only hope for a medal in Munich.
Let's take a look now at all four performances of Cathy Rigby, the little girl in a great big spot, 4'11", 89 pounds, from Los Alamitos, California. This, the uneven parallel bars.
And Jim, the American team came up very early, and as we can see, this is a fine, fine performance. And yet she doesn't score very high.
Well, Cathy got a mark of 9.20, and as Gordon Maddox indicates, that's a very important consideration that the American girls did so well today, despite the fact that they performed early in the morning when the judges feel that they have to leave themselves somewhere to go in the sense of high marks. Slow motion.
There's only one place where I see a concrete deduction. That's coming up right here. When her legs hit the bar, you see a slight knee break. There. And the rest is absolutely perfect, yet she only gets 9.2. That's unfortunate.
But 9.20 turned out to be not too bad because they marked fairly low today. Cathy Rigby now moved to her specialty, the balance beam, and here there was near disaster.
Well, we thought so for a long time, didn't we? Gosh, she works so strong. She's so aggressive. She's trying to work aggressive because she's been touted as a possible gold medal winner.
On this particular event.
Right.
Notice, by the way, that this is just about a full arena of 11,000 people. This event started at 8:30 in the morning, Munich time. This is the event in which she won the silver medal, America's first world championship medal at Yugoslavia 2 years ago.
She's working right up on the balls of her feet, not being particularly careful. She's very much at ease on the balance beam. But we're getting close to the place where she has her little problem. All the teams were required to do some kind of specific skills, and they've got a cartwheel thrown into this, and it's coming up now. She overbalances right there.
How she didn't fall off the beam, I have no idea, Gordon.
Well, I don't understand that either, and how she didn't lose her composure, because look at the finish.
Well, let's go back again and take a look in slow motion at how close she came to falling off the beam. You can see she was very upset at the performance.
Jim, we watched this morning from the end of the beam, and it was incredible that a girl could be that out of balance and still pull it back.
And so she did for a mark of 9.25, which turned out to be good enough for a tie for third place in this event at the moment. Rigby is in trouble in her quest of a gold medal. She moved then, however, with great composure to the floor exercises.
Jim, she doesn't feel this is her strongest event, and yet she earns the highest mark for either her or her team during the competition this morning in this event.
All the members of the American team performing to the music of Summer of 42. But now, this is compulsory. In what way is it compulsory? Do they do exactly the same things, or do them in a different order, or what?
Yes, the World Council says which tricks they have to do, and then each country has to put them together so that all members of the team do an identical exercise. They can select their own music, their own sequences, but the essential elements are identical.
All of the marks they get here, remember, counting toward a team championship and also towards individual finals. Finals for an all-around individual person, finals on each event. Cathy Rigby on the floor exercises, where she got a mark of 9.30. That was her highest mark of the day, and then she moved to the vaulting horse. Her first vault, they get two. Her first one was not so good. Then came the second vault, which was good enough for 9.10. Cathy Rigby with a fine all-around performance for the United States.